So here's a mapping app that I've already created. This one is identical to all the others that you've been using throughout this course. It has a single view, and there's a map fragment on that view. The Gradle file is set up for the Play Services libraries. And the manifest file is set up in the usual way with OpenGL, with the services libraries, with the API key, and with the permissions that I want to use. Internet access network state and write external storage. And of course, on my Google Developers console, as I showed you earlier on, I've configured this API for access through that API key, and the API key is here. Now let's take a look at the main activity. So in my main activity class, I've just created a number of local variables of marker options type, and I just named them after the various rinks: Renton, Kirkland, Everett, Linwood, Montlake, Kent, Showare. I've also created a camera position that I called Seattle, which is just the default camera position that I'm using when the application actually launches. Then in my onCreate function, I call the marker options in the way that I had demonstrated on the slide. So for example, Renton is new marker options with the latitude and longitude of Renton and the title Renton. I was able to get the latitudes and longitudes for each of the rinks using the technique that I showed earlier on, just using Google Maps, dropping a pin and reading the latitude and longitude from them. So I've set up all of my marker options for all of my rinks. And then in my onMapReady function, so remember, the onMapReady callback gets called when the map is ready because I've implemented onMapReady callback in my activity. So when the onMapReady gets called, I simply add all the markers to my map. So mmap.addMarkerRenton, mmap.addMarkerKirkland, etc. I add them all, and then I call flyToSeattle. And the flyTo function is very similar to the one that you saw in the previous demo, except this time I'm just moving the camera, I'm not animating it. So that I'm just going to fly to Seattle and I'm just going to jump into that location. I haven't put any fly to the particular rinks. The only time fly to has been called in this application is right at the beginning when I say fly to Seattle. And the only time that the fly to function is called is, of course, in the onMapReady when I fly to Seattle. So that will just give me a default view looking at Seattle in a location where we could see all of the rinks on the same map. So I had moved the camera to the appropriate location to allow me to do that. And that was the camera that was defined as Seattle. As you can see here, with the latitude, longitude, a zoom of 10, bearing of 0, so I'm looking straight down, and a tilt of 45 degrees. That was pretty simple, right? And in the next step, you're actually going to build a custom marker, so you're not going to use the default marker pin. You could create your own marker, for example, a hockey player. But before we get to that, let's have a little quiz about using markers on maps.